Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today in this video we are going to talk about MI, that is Xiaomi's recent launch of MI 10 Youth 5G phone. So in this video we are going to talk about its specs and my personal recommendations on whom should buy this phone. So basically, before going into this video about its specs and so, this MI 10 Youth is basically like a mid-range phone like K30. So you can't expect too much high specs from this model. That is the primary thing. And the next we are going to talk here is about its specs. So first let's talk about its primary specs. So primary specs in the sense, like there might be some people who may not know about the things about smartphones, but they will pucker, look into these things and they will buy. So for those people, the size, that is the screen size, is basically 6.57 inches and it comes in 6 GB and 8 GB RAM with 128 GB and 256 GB internal. So either 4 variants are available and you can choose anything you want. And in addition to that, it is Android 10 and it comes with 4120 mAh. So this is basically about its primary specs. So next we are going to talk about its in-depth. So in-depth, first we are going to talk about its display. So here in the display, it comes with Super AMOLED capacity touchscreen display. So basically, if you ask me what is this AMOLED, in the sense, you might know that if you take some older phones, whenever you use your finger to touch on the screen, basically there will be a layer which might be formed. So in the sense, your finger will be visible in the screen. So that is basically why, because on above of your screen there will be a surface, so like a layer, so where when you just use your fingers, the fingers are visible. So but whereas when you come to AMOLED display, both the display and the screen will be combined together and forms a single display. That is the main thing. So this AMOLED display is so good. And if you ask me more, in the market, basically there are two displays available. One is AMOLED and on the other side it is IPS LCD. So if you ask me the difference, so basically IPS is basically like what to say, if you're using some white and colors, then during those times IPS is so good. But when you use dark colors like in black or in dark room and so, in those cases AMOLED display is good. But basically like what to say, the company's point of view and the company is responsible for choosing either of those depending upon the cost that they want to invest in that phone model. So that is basically about this display. So in addition to that, next we have to talk about its aspect ratio. So aspect ratio, in the sense, your phone size is 6.57 inches. So it doesn't mean that your screen size is also the same. So to know about your screen size, this aspect ratio plays a very important role. So here the aspect ratio is basically 20:9. So 20 is your length and 9 is your breadth. So please note that. And in addition to that, if you want more things, then you have to pucker know about its screen to body ratio. So here the screen to body ratio is basically 85%. So in the sense, if you take 100% phone, 85% is covered with your screen, whereas your rest 15% is covered with your body, in the sense like back and the edges and so. So that is the main thing about its display. And the next thing we have to talk about its pixels. So here it comes with 1080 x 2400 pixels. So in the sense, you can go for 2K, and in this phone there is HDR10+, Full HD plus, so you can do all sort of those things in this phone with help of that display. And the next thing which comes in the display point is basically PPI. So PPI, in the sense, it is basically pixel per inch. So pixel per inch, in the sense, suppose if you are taking some photos in older phones and if you are trying to zoom it out, when you try to zoom, you can just find the photo may not be zoomed and you can just find a square available there. So that is basically due to this PPI. So in this phone, the PPI density is basically 401, which is quite good, because if you're having phones more than 400, then you can zoom well irrespective of its camera features. So this is the main thing of its display. And next thing which I want to talk here about display is basically about its refresh rate. So this refresh rate is basically for gamers and so who's interested in gaming and so. Please note that your refresh rate should be as high as possible irrespective of its RAM. So in this phone, the refresh rate is 60 hertz. So 60 hertz is okay, because there are some good mid-range phones with 90 hertz and 120 hertz, whereas 60 hertz is so less. So a refresh rate, in the sense, suppose if you're playing some top end games like PUBG and so, and if you're trying to turn the screen suddenly from this side to that side and so, you can just see there might be some lag irrespective of its data or Wi-Fi connection and so, but still you'll have some small lag. That lag is basically due to this refresh rate. So in this phone, the refresh rate is basically 60 hertz, and in addition to that, about its sampling touch rate. So sampling touch rate, in the sense, suppose if you're using some social medias like WhatsApp or Instagram and so, and if you're typing some messages, you might have noticed that after you have typed using your fingers, but it will take like maybe like 1 or 2 seconds lag to make that words or letters to appear on your screen. That is basically due to this touching rate. So here the touching rate is basically 1030 hertz, which is also okay, because there are mid-range phones with 240 200 and so. So that is the main thing. So this is basically about its whole display thing about this MI10. So the next thing which we are going to talk here about is processor. So basically this phone comes with Snapdragon 765G chipset. So basically it will work on 5G. And in addition to that, it comes with Android 10, which is also good. And the main thing is about its configuration. Like, it's clubbing with 6GB or 8GB RAM with 120GB or 256GB internal. And there is no SD card. Dedicated, no SD card available, and so basically your dual SIM and both the SIMs will work on 5G. So this is basically about its processing side. And in addition to that, next we are going to talk about its camera. So camera, in the sense, the front or rear will be a quad-cam camera. So basically it has four cameras, so 48 plus 8 plus 8 plus 2. So your 48 megapixel will be your primary camera, whereas your 8 megapixel will be your ultra wide lens, and followed by your next 8 pixel is a perioptical camera. So perioptical, in the sense, here you can do 10x in digital videos, and 5x when you're taking some photos and so. That is so good. And your next, followed by 2 megapixel, will be for your zooming, so optical zoom, macro lens and so. So this is basically about its camera rear, whereas your selfie, here it comes with 16 megapixel. And the main thing about this selfie camera here, it is water drop notch. So in the sense, it is somewhat old technology, because nowadays smartphones are coming with punch hole camera. So that is small changes and small important thing which you have to notice about its camera part. And followed by here it comes with 3.5mm jack. And talking about its fingerprint, here it comes on the screen. That is also so good. And basically speakers are available, stereo speakers. And Wi-Fi, it works on all Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi 5, 6, dual band A, B, G, N, A, C, all sorts. So that is also a thing. And last thing about its price. So price, in the sense, as I told, there are four variants. So it comes around from 21,000 to 30,000 depending upon your variants. So in basically it comes around like 300 to 400 US dollars. So that's it about its price. Where about its colors? It comes in 5 colors, like a black, blue, green, orange, peach and so. So which colors you want, you can just go for it. That's it. So this phone is basically going to be launched on China on May 5th, and there might be some confirmations, like after 1 or 2 months it might be going to be launched in India. But due to this coronavirus and so, we can just expect it somewhat like 3 or 4 months. So this is basically about its MI10. So next is my personal recommendation. So basically, if you are interested in gaming or gamers and so, please don't go for this phone. So that is my primary request, because refresh rate is not good. You will just think, oh god, the RAM is so good, so I can go for it. RAM is not so much important when you compare to refresh rate. So please understand that one thing. So if you're a gamer or gaming, please don't go for this phone. And the next thing, whereas in camera you can go for this phone, because for 20,000 getting those specs like 48 8 8 opticals and so is so good. So if you're interested in camera, photography, social media stuffs, do go for this phone. I would suggest you for camming stuff. But whereas in gaming, my personal recommendation, please don't go for it. So this is basically about MI10 Youth Edition. So hope so you like this video. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. So like this content. I'll just meet you in the next video. So till then, peace from K Square. Bye.